Hello friends, in this video I will show you how to use date picker dialog and time picker dialog together to pick date and time, and how to save the date and time which is picked in shared preferences so that you can use it again in date picker dialog and time picker dialog. So here I will create a new empty project in Android Studio and I will name it as dialog. Now this is going to be a long video and I will set the language to Java and minimum SDK version 21. Then I click finish. So now it will create an empty project which will take some time. So I'll just pause it here. So now it has created this empty project and it contains a main activity and activity main. In build.grader, you can see that it contains these libraries. The important ones are AndroidX, AppCompat, and the material library, and a constraint layout library. So let's go to activity main.xml. Here they have a constraint layout and inside this a text view. In this I will be adding a button. When the button is clicked, I will pick date and time and display it in the text view. So for this button I will set the constraints: the left constraint, right constraint, top constraint, which all these are the parent, and the bottom constraint will be this text view. Now for these two I will set the text size. And for the button, I will set the text to pick time. Now this looks fine. Now let's go to main activity. Here I will define the button and text view. Now text view is not required to be defined here. I will only define the button. Button 1 is equal to button. This is the ID of the button. After this, here the onCreate ends. So in the onCreate, I will set onClickListener for the button. This is the onClick listener for button, and in this onClick event I will display the date picker dialog first and then the time picker dialog. So this is the code which I will use from apktutor.com. This is my site and I will provide a link to the codes which I use in description of the video. So here is the date picker dialog. From this I will copy the class date picker dialog. There is this public static class date picker fragment. I will copy this and paste it after the onCreate event. It should be here the onCreate event ends, and after this I will add this date picker fragment. This is the name of the fragment and you can name it anything, like my date picker fragment. And you have to import all these things. So here I will import this dialog fragment. Then I will import the date picker dialog. Okay, it is extends dialog fragment, implements date picker dialog dot on date set listener. Inside this, there is a calendar class. I will import this calendar also. Then I have to import the dialog. These statements can be removed. And this is the onDateSet event. here there is a date picker. I will import this. Then it has defined an edit text. This is not required now. So this is the date picker fragment. So when the date picker fragment is shown, it will display, it will get the current time, then it will display the current year, month and day. Here you can see that the Y, M and D are set to the current calendar year, month and day of month. Okay, so to display it in on button click, I will write my date picker fragment. Fragment 1 is equal to new my date picker fragment, and in next line I'll write fragment 1 dot show get support fragment manager comma, there should be a tag for this, so that will be date picker DP. Yeah, so that's all is required for showing the date picker fragment. Now the time picker fragment. So here I'll go back and select this time picker dialog, and here I will copy the time picker fragment, public static class time picker fragment. And I will paste it after the date picker fragment class, which ends here. So here I will paste this time picker fragment. So I have already imported dialog fragment. Now I have to import time picker dialog. This will import the time picker dialog, and it implements time picker dialog dot on time set listener. Then this is the calendar current time, and the hour is set to the current time hour of day, and minute is the current minute. And initially it displays this hour and minute. Now the date format is set to is 24 hour format, and here I will set it date format. I have to import this date format. There are three options here. I will select this first one, android.txt.format. Next is on time set event. Here we have to import the time picker. And then we have to get the text view and set the text of that text view. I will just remove it from here for now. Now to display this time picker fragment, when the date is set, I will be using this similar code in on date set event. I will use this code in on date set event. So here, instead of my date picker fragment, it will be time picker fragment. Okay, the name is time picker fragment. I will just copy it from here. So this is time picker fragment equal to new time picker fragment, and I will name it as fragment 2. And now it will be fragment 2.show get support fragment manager. Here we have to add one more line, get activity. Get activity dot get support fragment manager comma the time picker. Here the tag will be TP. You can write anything here. So I have written TP. So this will display the time picker fragment when the date is set. Now we need shared preferences. So here I will define shared preferences SP. Okay, here I have declared shared preferences SP, and after defining pattern 1, I will define this shared preferences SP is equal to get shared preferences SP comma mode private activity dot mode private. Now I have to use it in this static class my date picker fragment, I will be required to make it static, make the shared preferences static. But let's try this. First I will set this int y m and d equal to 0. Okay, next I will use an if else block, if else code. If sp dot get string year dot equals empty. So if the year saved in SP, which is shared preferences, is empty, then I will set this y to this one. Control C, Control V. Okay, y will be set to the current calendar's year. Else, if the year saved is not empty, then I will set this y to now dot, okay, it will be sp dot get string year comma empty string. This is the default value. Now this is a string and y is an int, so we have to convert it to int, and for that first we'll convert it to double. So here I will write double dot parse double, and I will add this int here. Now for this sp to be used in the dialog fragment, we have to define it static. So here I have defined it static, and the calendar which we are using here in this date picker dialog, we have to use the same calendar in time picker dialog also, so we have to define it outside. So I will just cut it from here, triple click Control X, and I will paste it here at the top. And since we have to use it in the static classes, we have to define it static. So now we have this static calendar and static shared preferences. The calendar is now. Let's go back to date picker fragment. So here I have defined the year, and this is used here. We do not need this. Now I will define the month and day in same way. So I'll copy this. This will be the initial year, month and day, which will be displayed in the dialog, date picker dialog. So here I will set M to calendar.month, and I will save it as month. Here also it will be M, and this will be month. And for day, I will use the string day for saving the day. Then the current day will be day of month. This is done. Now we do not need these two lines of code. It will return new date picker dialog, get activity this and YMD. Okay, and when do we save it? We will save it in on date set. In on date set, we will save the shared preferences. We will set the values in shared preference. So it will be sp.edit.putString. The first string will be year, comma, we have to set the value of this year, so that will be string dot value of year dot commit. So here this year is same as the year which is there in this. So this is the year, month and the day which is selected. The month starts from 0, so we have to add 1 to it. Now I will save the month. Month and day, and this will be month and day. This is fine. So on date set, I save the year, month and day which is set, and then I show the time picker fragment. In time picker fragment, I will use similar code to show the saved time and minute, saved hour and minute. So let's go to time picker. Here we'll use the same calendar which is now. In date picker, you can see we used the calendar now, and this is the name of the calendar. So here we'll set the INT, let's make it H, and the INT MIN is equal to 0. Then for now we have to get the current time. So here I will use now is equal to calendar dot get instance. This will be the current time, and now we can use it here. So here first I will use r, sp.getString r equals empty, then h will be now dot r of day, else this h will be the r saved in shared preferences. Next is the minute, that I will save as MIN, and we have to set, if that is empty then we set it to minute from the calendar, else we set MIN to the MIN saved in shared preferences. Now I can remove it from here, and it will return H and MIN. This will be the initial hour and minute. Now we have to save the hour and minute in on time set. So here I will be using this similar code. this will be hour, H O U R, and this will be minute, MIN, and this will be set to hour of day. This is here, you can see it is hour of day, and this one is minute. So I'll set the MIN to minute. Now after this, I have to display the date and the time. So for that, I need a string. I will define a static string here. Static string date time equal to empty. Now let's go to date picker dialog. On date set, I will set this string date time. Date time equal to day plus month plus year. And on time set, I will set it to date time is equal to date time plus the hour and minute. So here I will add comma space. Plus hour of day plus this symbol plus minute. And to display it in text view, I have to define the text view. So here I will define text view. Text view 1 is equal to get activity dot find view by id r dot id dot text view. And now in text view 1, I can display this date and time. Text view 1 dot set text date time. That's all. Now let's check this. So here you can see the app. When I click this button, it displays a date picker dialog and it displays the earlier I had saved the date, so it is displaying 8 September. But currently the date is 19th September, so let me select 19th September and click OK. Then it displays the time picker dialog. Now I have selected 9:15 here, 9:15 PM. Let me select AM, 9:15 AM. And when I click OK, it will display 19:21, 9:15. This is the 24-hour format. Now suppose I click again, then it will display the date which I had selected earlier, which is 19. I'll select 5 here, 5 September 2021. And here in time picker, you can see that it displays 9:15 AM. So now I will select 10:15 AM. Okay, and it sets it to 5 September. Now when I again click here, it should display 5 September and 10:15. So here you can see it displays 5 September and the time is 10:15 AM. So you can see that it remembers the date and time which we have set. So that's all in this video. Thank you very much for watching this.